CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello learners of class 6. Welcome to the wonderful world of English language classroom. Learners, first of all let me thank you for having participated in the first lesson very well. Sirath, let me also thank you. Sirath, how do you feel having done the first part of the lesson?
It was very interesting while doing the multiple choice questions and true and false and many activities
Very good. So some learning has taken place. You have understood the story. So I'm happy about it, learners. Now today in this lesson, Sirath and learners, we will do some vocabulary. There's some words, new words we have come across in the story. And also we will do some rhyming words which you have come across in the story. So I believe that you have read the story more than 2-3 times. So the objectives of this lesson, learners, we are going to read and comprehend the story, Who Did Patrick Swamak, use words and phrases in context and for purposes, learn and use some rhyming words in context. Sirath, you must have wondered, generally when we say rhyming words from class 1 onwards, we may have learned, you have learned, rhyming words only we identify in a poem, not in prose, is it, or a story. So that's interesting in this story. Learners, you come across some very good rhyming words very well to the actions of Patrick and the elf. So we will learn some rhyming words, followed by we will do some listening activity. I'm going to do a kind of dictation, but in a different manner. Get ready, learners. Now, let's read some sentences. Let's begin with the reading of some sentences from the story. Let me ask Sirath to read. There are 3-4 sentences. Come on, read.
And it is true, sometimes he did feel like an enormous. The little man's face wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in a hamper. He grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. Patrick got his A's, his classmates were amazed.
Fine. Let me also read out for you learners and Sirath. And it is true, sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. The word is ignoramus. The little man's face wrinkled like dishcloth thrown in the hamper. Dishcloth. He grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. Patrick got his A's and his classmates were amazed. The words are ignoramus, dishcloth, grimaced, scowled and amazed. Come on, let me ask you, Sirath. Ignoramus. What do you think is the meaning of the word?
It is like ignoring something.
Careless. Sometimes we say in Hindi, no? Chalta hai. Kuch bhi, he doesn't do anything and feels like, oh, come on, let things go on. Dishcloth.
Dishcloth, a thing which we can use to
wash the
wipe the dish.
Yeah, and wash it and wipe it after washing. Grimaced and scowled.
Grimace, a grumpy action.
Yes. Grimace, you know, sometimes some people irritate you, you grimace and scowl. You make a kind of irritating way you express your feeling. And the next one, everybody knows, Patrick got his A's, his classmates were amazed. What is amazement? Amazing.
Praising, surprise.
Yeah, surprise and good achievement. It's a kind of achievement. Learners, these are the words. We have somehow given you the meaning. I'm not going to give you exact dictionary meaning. That's for you, your job to consult the dictionary. Sirath has done it already. Come on, learners, you do it. But what I'm going to do is, I'm going to ask you to use the words in sentences. I've got 5-6 sentences and I'm going to give these words with another word which is not suitable for this sentence. You have to use the right word. Ready? Come on, sentence 1. You have to pick up any one of the words and fill in the blanks. I feel my brother is dash most of the time. He doesn't know many things. use any one of these words, ignoramus or rude.
I will use ignoramus.
Then read the sentence.
I feel my brother is ignoramus. Most of the time, he does not know many things.
So, I feel my brother is ignoramus. Most of the time, he doesn't know many things. He feels like knowing everything. The second sentence, I always wash dish cloth or dish after cleaning the utensil.
I will choose dish cloth.
Fine.
I always wash dish cloth after cleaning the utensils.
Fine. Third sentence, Ravi grimace or jubilant and scowl or celebrate when he was wrongly punished. Let me read out in a different manner. Ravi dash grimace or jubilant and dash scowl or celebrate when he was wrongly punished.
I will choose in the first dash grimaced and the second one is scowled. Ravi grimaced and scowled when he was wrongly punished.
Okay. Ravi grimaced and scowled when he was wrongly punished. It's quite natural for anyone. If you punish a person for no reason,
no one likes it.
Yeah, okay. Sentence 4. Most of the time, we do not know our ignoramus or nice behavior. Later, we realize it. Let me say it again. Most of the time, we do not know our dash ignoramus or nice behavior. Later, we realize it.
Most of the time, we do not know our ignoramus behavior. Later, we realize it.
Fine. It happens with everybody. Now, dash is important thing in a kitchen. Dish cloth or dish? Both are?
Both are important.
Yes. Let me say a different manner. Dash is an important thing in a kitchen. Dish cloth or a fridge?
Dish cloth.
Dish cloth. Okay. Sixth one, the last one. When the dog saw the monkey, it dash and dash. You have to choose from the four words, grimace, jubilant, scowl, feel happy. So let me say the sentence again. When the dog saw the monkey, it dash and dash. There are four words. Select two words. Grimace, jubilant, scowl, feel happy.
Grimaced and scowled.
Come on, say the sentence. Use it.
When the dog saw the monkey, it grimaced and scowled.
Fine. Learners, let me take you back to the story again for your understanding. Myself and Sirat, we are going to read the summary again for you in order to make you understand the story better again before we move on to next story. Come on. Let me read out. You start, Sirat.
Patrick did not want to complete his homework because he hated homework and liked to play sports.
One day, Patrick's cat got an elf and was playing with it.
The elf saw Patrick and asked him to save from the cat.
The elf promised Patrick that it would grant him a wish in return.
Patrick agreed and told the elf that he had to complete all Patrick's homework till the end of the semester.
The elf reluctantly agreed, but he told Patrick that he would need his help because the elf did not know how to do homework.
Every day, the elf asked Patrick his help by making Patrick to find words in the dictionary, add or subtract maths problems.
The elf made him to do all the homework.
Finally, on the last day, when the school was over, the elf slipped from the back door.
When the results were out, Patrick got an A.
His teachers, parents and classmates were surprised and happy to see Patrick's achievement.
Patrick has now become a very nice, active boy in learning and taking care of himself. Learners, that is the story. We have said it again. We have done some vocabulary. Now let's move on to do some rhyming words, then some listening activity. Sirat, if you look at the book, the first lesson, you will find some interesting usage of language. Means, there's a paragraph, let me read out to you learners, page number 10, paragraph 7. Page 10, para 7. So let me read out the sentence, the paragraph, only three sentences. You will understand something interesting happening. As a matter of fact, every day in every way, that little elf was a nag. Patrick was working harder than ever, was it a drag. He was staying up nights, had ever felt so weary, was going to school with his eyes puffed and blurry. Learners, look at the words nag, drag, weary and blurry. This is rhyming. These words are rhyming with each other. Nag, drag, weary and blurry. Sirat, fine?
Yes.
These are rhyming words. How well the author uses them. He brings a doubt in the actions of elf. He says, was it a drag? And elf was a nag. So you know the nagging people. Fine? He was staying up nights. He had ever felt so weary. And was going to school with his eyes puffed and blurry. So blurry and weary. So learners, Sirat, I am going to give you a challenge. I am going to say some such rhyming words. You will have to supply a matching rhyming word. So now find the rhyming words or the words which I am going to read out. Okay, first one, let me tell you as an example. Nice rice. Sirat, come on. You do along with the learner. Thing.
Ring.
Make.
Lake or take.
Fine. Car.
Bar or tar.
Fine. Never.
Ever.
Where. Where. W-E-R. Where.
W-E-R-E. Where.
Where. Okay. Where. Where. And even W-E-R-E. And W-H-E-R-E. Fine. Where. Where. Take.
Make.
Fine. Now I'm going to ask you to read all the words. Both the words.
Nice. Rice. Thing. Ring. Make. Lake or take. Car. Bar or tar. Ever. Never. Wear. W-E-R-E. Wear. W-H-E-R-E. Wear. Take or make.
Fine. Thank you. Thank you, Sirat. You can find as many words possible when you read a poem or a text. Come on. Learners, thank you very much for that activity. Now, little more serious challenge for you. Learners, you must have read the story more than once. Some people may have read more than two, three times. We will now do an interesting task. I'm going to read out a paragraph from the lesson, Who Did Patrick's Homework? You will listen to it carefully. You will listen to the paragraph completely, whatever I read out. Then start writing in a paper. I want to test whether you have listened to the whole thing properly. If someone is near with you, you can discuss. If it is done in the classroom, you can do it as a pair work or group work. Here, if you are, no one is there, you may do it as an individual work. Is the instruction clear? I will read out 5 sentences. You will have to listen all the 5 sentences, then start writing. Okay, fine. I'm not bothered if you have written something different slightly, but the meaning has to come. You may have written different words, but many. Come on. Learners, ready? Sirat, ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. And his parents, they wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. Come on, Sirat. Recreate.
Patrick was having A's and his classmates were happy to see that. His teachers were amazed and surprised and were full of his praise. And his parents were wondering that what happened to Patrick. He was now the active kid who did all his chores and was a model as a model for his classmates.
Fine. Learners, I don't know what you have written. You may read out to yourself or your parents or siblings there. You check it out. I am going to read out again what you have written. Sirath has captured more or less nearer to it. Some words and phrases changed. He even said more than what I dictated. Come on, fine. Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. And his parents, they wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. Learners, Sirath, you've done it. Come on. I'm going to ask you, give you another such listening activity. This is a story you must have come across. Listen to it carefully. I may read out twice, then start writing. Okay? The dog and the bone. A dog was walking over a bridge with a piece of meat in its mouth. Suddenly, he saw his reflection in the river. He thought that it was another dog. He barked at the reflection. The piece of meat fell into the river. Fine learners, you must have done it. Sirath, what have you written? Come on, read out.
A dog was walking, was going, and with a piece of meat in his mouth, and suddenly there was a reflection of water, and he thought that there was another dog in the water, so he barked at the reflection that he could see, and the piece of meat fell into the water.
Fine. Thank you, Sirath, for you have brought the whole meaning of the story. Fine. Come on, let me read out so that you can check it out, learners and Sirath. A dog was walking over a bridge with a piece of meat in its mouth. Suddenly, he saw his reflection in the water. He thought that it was another dog. He barked at the reflection. The piece of meat fell into the river. Learners, don't bother if you have written slightly different or even with much difference. What is needed is you should bring back the meaning of the story. So that Sirath has done it. I hope you also have done it. Learners, thank you very much. You have done all the activities well. And Sirath, let me thank you for participating actively. Learners, we will meet you in the next lesson or next part with much more activities, much more fun. Thank you very much. Read the lesson. Keep learning. Listening to the radio station. And Sirath, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I had a lot of fun here with these learners and all my friends. So I will like to come on this place and just talk to you and do interesting activities like this and have so much of fun.
Sirath, thank you very much. Keep reading and learning.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.